In this video, I am going to explain basic anatomy of ligaments around knee joint. There are a bunch of ligaments around knee joint, so I am going to explain one by one. From first picture, I am going to explain anterior view, anterior ligaments. First one is this one. This is medial patellofemoral ligament. Medial patellofemoral ligament. It's like a transverse connective tissue. If there is medial patellofemoral ligament, there should be lateral, which is this one. This is lateral patellofemoral ligament. Lateral, same thing, lateral patellofemoral ligament. Okay, these are like a transverse direction. Now there is longitudinal direction. Medial one is medial patella ligament. Medial patella ligament, which is this one, this blue one. This is medial patella ligament. There's lateral one. This is lateral patella ligament. Lateral patella ligament. 1, 2, 3, 4. And what is this one? This is medial collateral ligament. Medial collateral ligament, also known as MCL, right? This is very important for medial knee stabilization. Again, if there's medial, there should be lateral. This one, this is lateral collateral ligament. Lateral collateral ligament. This is LCL. Okay, and one more thing, there's ligament between meniscus. This is also a transverse way. This is transverse ligament. Transverse ligament. This ligament connects medial meniscus and lateral meniscus. Now let's go to posterior view. This is posterior view of knee joint. Again, this is LCL. This is MCL. What is this one? This is oblique popliteal ligament. Oblique popliteal ligament. This is literally oblique. It's diagonal. Next one is this kind of fan-shaped ligament. This is arcuate popliteal ligament. Arcuate popliteal ligament. There is kind of a fascial connection between two ligaments. Okay, and for your information, there is one of hamstrings attached to oblique popliteal ligament, and you can follow this kind of a myofascial connection. This is semimembranosus, you know, just for your information. Semimembranosus to oblique popliteal ligament to arcuate popliteal ligament. Very important. Next one is this one, this pink one is posterior cruciate ligament. Posterior cruciate ligament, also known as PCL. Very famous ligament. One more ligament, which is this one. You know, this looks like PCL, however, it's not. This is posterior meniscofemoral ligament. posterior, menisco, femoral ligament. As this name reflects, this ligament attaches to femur and meniscus. There's one more ligament that attaches to meniscus, right? That is transverse ligament. I just show you in first picture, right? So, there are ligaments around meniscus. What happens if these ligaments get tight or these ligaments ruptures? That aggravate mechanics of meniscus. If meniscus is aggravated, that aggravates whole knee mechanics. That is why tension or health of ligament is crucial for knee health. Make sense? This is very important. Now let's go to lateral view. This is lateral view. This is LCL. There is one ligament that is close to LCL, which is like this one. This is newly found in 2013. This is anterolateral ligament. Anterolateral ligament. This ligament, again, is very close to LCL. Maybe one of these ligaments get torn. That can affect the other one. Maybe injury of LCL can affect anterolateral ligament. Vice versa, when anterolateral ligament gets ruptured, that may affect LCL. Very interesting relationship. I have explained many ligaments today, but I think I missed one famous ligament. What is it? Let me explain the last one. Okay, this is anterior view, and the other tissues are invisible. It's like a see-through view. So last one is this one. This is anterior cruciate ligament. Anterior cruciate ligament. This is ACL. ACL, the most famous ligament in knee joint. This is ACL. It's very deep ligament. That is why I couldn't show you this ligament like other pictures. Anyway, this is ACL. With PCL together, these are very important. Anterior cruciate ligament. Posterior cruciate ligament. Very important structure. Again, there are many knee ligaments around joint. Why is that? Because tibia is very flat structure. It's flat surface. Now, femur is on flat surface. Do you think this is very stable? It's kind of ball on table. It's very unstable. I know there is meniscus on top of tibia, but it's not very deep concave surface. It's very shallow. It's very unstable. That is why ligaments that connect bone to bone is very important. If one of these ligaments get ruptured, that affects knee movement, knee stabilization a lot. That is why knee ligaments are crucial for knee health. In this video, I explained the basic anatomy of knee ligaments. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.